morning. I'm fired up because I was about to choose to go to the Johnny Hallyday exhibition. So for people who don't know Johnny Hallyday, he's like the French Elvis Presley. And there is a big exhibition. So I was about to choose there, but I decided still to come this morning. So my name is Thibaut Serol. I'm a partner at Atomico. Atomico is, I imagine most of you know Atomico. It's a European tech VC funded by founders, for founders. And we are operating since 2006 with more than 120 companies such as Stripe, Klarna, Supercell, Ivan, and the MessageBird, this kind of company. The session of this morning is not to talk about Atomico, but to talk exactly what we were mentioning right now regarding scaling in turbulent times. So just before jumping into the presentation, just to introduce myself, so I joined Atomico around a year ago. I'm not coming from a VC background. I'm coming from an operating background because I worked 22 years for software companies and tech companies. And the last one, in late 2016, I was the first employee outside the US and the European founder for Snowflake. So I started all activities for Snowflake in Europe, and I helped to scale the business in 14 different countries. The first 3 years we did, we went from zero. I started in a very small office alone, and we went from zero to $112 million of ARR. And I left Snowflake 9 months after the company has been public. I joined the company when the company was like $200 million of market capitalization, first employee outside the US, and I left when the company was valued around $50 billion. So I joined Atomico. Why? To help startup on this growth journey. And this is what we will talk about today. So, many people are young in this room, so they didn't necessarily go through different crises before. But what European tech right now is living is probably the biggest downturn since the financial crisis of 2008. And this period so has been extremely difficult. But right now, we see, even if we see some progresses, the idea of this presentation of today is focusing on fundamental things. Because this period, even if it's a difficult one, and compared to late 2021, where the hyper-focus was on growth, we move from that to move to profitability and to move to solutions that are able to provide good return on investments. So, to start with, you can build up the best solution on the planet, but what is extremely important is to excel at every stage. And it's not an option. And what we mean by that is every single company that succeeds, I mean very large scale company, yes, they had a very good product, yes, they had a very good founders, but also they were able to excel at every stage. And what I mean by excel at every stage is on the sales side, being able to have one single messaging extremely clear when you talk to different customers. I saw so many startups right now that have great ideas, and the way they pitch, sometimes it's more regarding what they have in mind, but it's not necessarily clear for the on the customer side. And this is something extremely important, to have one single messaging extremely consistent. On the sales side, when we are starting and we are a startup and we are fired up, and I will share some stories, sometimes we accept many meetings, but it's very important to be extremely clear on qualify in or out opportunities, because when you are at the beginning, you cannot go and meet every single customer. Excelling means also hiring the right talents. And on this, so I was talking about this yesterday with one of my colleagues, and we met a startup. I was in Oslo yesterday, and the head of product said, okay, we want to hire A players. I think everybody wants to hire A players, obviously, and not B players, but the reality to attracting them, finding them, qualifying the right candidates, it's something where you probably need help sometimes. It's extremely important to be to never compromise. The time you have something in your gut that is something that you feel is not right regarding someone, you pay back this extremely badly. Sometimes we auto-convince ourselves because some people have specific background on our industry, but it doesn't mean that necessarily those people will be the right one to grow with the company. So it's you need courage, because when you start, it's difficult to hire people. It's difficult to attract, but you can build some core activities to attract and qualify and bring the right talents. Excelling, it means also having a sales process. Excelling means having some different stage that you need to respect. So I saw so many companies that have the way of qualifying opportunities, but it's most of the time a must have, but not really something that is extremely well focused and used. And this is something where the more you will grow in your career, the more your company will grow, the more accurate you will need to be on forecast. And forecast, because when you will speak to investors, they will want to see that you are under control of your business. And this is extremely important. So the risk of playing by the books. So I love reading books, and business books, but the world is surrounded by so many books right now. And yesterday, when I came from Oslo, I was sitting close to someone in the plane, and she had a brand new baby. And why I'm talking about this? Because it's exactly the analogy can be exactly the same. When if you have young parents in the room, you will see that when you have your first kids, everybody will give you advice on how to grow your kids. Sometimes people have no kids, but they will still give you some advice. But the reality is different, obviously, by child. And it's a little bit the same analogy when we are talking about companies. Because if you want to apply, if you try to enforce things that you see in books and you don't inspire or take advantage of what is it and try to just apply, it doesn't work necessarily. So for example, many discussions I have with startups are, okay, how do I build leading indicators for my sales team? So how I will monitor the success of my team? And the by the books event is really, sometimes some people can arrive with like 10, 12 different KPI when you are very early stage. And it's probably a mistake. And to give you another analogy, I'm a big fan of ski. And if you learn to ski right now, if someone is telling you, okay, the 50 different things that you need to do, you will probably fall and you will probably break your leg. But if you just say, okay, you need to have your shin touching your boots and you need to see your gloves, it's a good start. And it's exactly the same when you start a company. At the beginning, when you are early stage, you need to focus on awareness. Awareness around the product, around the company, around the solution. And probably the two leading indicators to monitor at the beginning is the number of new business meetings, the number of new introductions, meetings that you will do facing a new customer. And probably the second one is the number of new customers, the brand new one. Why? Because if you have this will help you to focus on the right awareness. We were maniacally focused in Snowflake to have a number of brand new customers, and this was the two things that we monitored the first 2 years. We didn't care even about the size of deals sometimes, because the most important for us was to build awareness and to have people to talk about your technology. Maintaining focused and consistency, and I will probably add simplicity to that. And on maintaining focus, it's extremely important, because when you start, you can be surrounded and you are all with a very innovative concept sometimes. And last week I was in Paris, and I met a great company that we are evaluating, and the founder was saying, we want to evangelize the market. And it's a big risk of doing that when you do when you do this kind of exercise, because you can lose control. Focus, what does it mean? It means that you will focus on the right customer profile, the right ICP, the right use case that you can really replicate instead of going all over the planet. And I will share with you a little story. When I was in Snowflake, so initially we did a great job at doing a lot of pipeline, and I managed to get a meeting with a very large bank in the UK, with the CIO and all the group of executives. I organized this meeting, so I decided to bring the CEO. I bring also the two founders, because the founders of the company were not the CEO, two French fantastic guys. So we were extremely well prepared. We did the meeting. I arrived at this big bank. They asked me to wear a tie, because you needed this period of time to wear a tie to go in meetings. So it was in 2016. We did the meeting. Everything went well, and after that, the CIO said, "Thank you, now I understand what the cloud means." So it was why I'm talking about this. So first, I was like château de cartes, as we say in French, so it means that the world exploded around me, because I bring some people from the US, I bring everyone to come with me, but at the end, they come to see us to be educated on the market. So during all this process, so the night after, I didn't sleep. And the morning following that day, I bring the entire team with me, and I said, OK, we'll stop doing that. We'll stop accepting every single meeting with every single company. Yes, we have a fancy solution, and it's easy to get meetings. But the problem is those companies are not ready. They are not ready to go to the cloud. So now they are a customer, but it took a lot of time. So what we did, we defocus from accepting every meeting, and we say, okay, we'll focus only on online retailers, technology companies, and the only thing we will do is we will focus on the replacement of Amazon Redshift. So sorry for the AWS person that was here before, but it was our strategy during 2 years. It was our strategy when we open every single country without deviation. So the only way to do that was qualification, to make sure that we were going after the right people, going after the right company, and we were focusing on the right use case where we knew we were strong. And when we had the right size of deals, then we were able to grow after that. Consistency is probably where most startups fail. And this is extremely difficult. So for example, right now, so I met around 82 companies since I started in last September. And I think on 82 companies, probably on 80 out of them, we talk about, okay, I want to drive more pipeline. I need to have more pipeline. I was product-led growth, and now I want to really focus on having more pipeline. And the pipeline thing is, there is no secret recipe. If you are not consistent on the way you organize your pipeline generation, every single week, the team that I had, from the first week we started, every single week, one day was dedicated to pipeline generation. People arrived prepared with the kind of accounts they will call during that day. At the end of the day, we were regrouping. Everybody was sharing experiences, objection handling, and also the right success. But we were consistent every single week. Since 2016, Snowflake is doing that still now in 2023, because I had the team last week on that. Consistency means that when you hire someone, you don't compromise. You don't compromise on the core qualities of your companies. The number of mistakes I did of hiring people just because they had a network or they had customers that they can bring, but I had something in my gut saying, okay, probably this will be difficult for us in terms of culture, and we pay back this extremely badly. So you need to be extremely consistent on that. Being financially cautious and ROI-minded. So, as I said, we shifted from a super high growth mindset to profitability and solution that are right now with a very strong ROI. So building a high ROI, it's not something necessarily easy, but you need to also to work on that. The question you need to ask yourself is, what is the impact of doing nothing for customers? If they don't use your solution, what is the impact for them? If you are not able to articulate this with the right metrics, with the right hard dollars behind, this will be extremely difficult. Most companies right now, to justify investments, they need proper ROI. Honestly, I won't lie to you, it's difficult, but it's an absolute necessity to spend some time to compare a before state, analyzing, understanding, having some metrics, and compare that to an after state using your solution and what would be the impact and the ROI associated. So, all of this remain positive, don't worry, because it's also the right time to build great foundations. So I don't have time to cover everything right now, but it's the right time right now to build a culture of accountability, a culture of focus that I was mentioning, a culture of fun, but driving accountability, something I was using with my team. Very early stage, I asked them the question, when you face the mirror in your bathroom every morning, ask yourself, do I contribute to the success of my company today? Do I really contribute with everything I'm doing? And you need to be honest out of this. Your team needs to be extremely honest out of this. It's time to develop people and make them feeling that they are on something special. And it's time also to help your customers, because some customers are facing difficulties. And the best way to build very strong champions is to focus on helping them when you don't have anything to ask. This will be the best way to have very strong relationship with your customers. So everyone knows those different companies. Why I show them right now? Because all those companies have been created just after 2008. All those companies were created when the world fell apart on the finance and the banking industry, but they were able to build the right foundations. They were able to build the right products, and right now they are extremely successful startup because they took the time to really focusing on the right things. There has never been a better time to be an entrepreneur. So two things I would say to finish, because I'm late. The first thing is it's very important when you start right now. Sometimes we have the tendency of thinking, and also you work with a VC and people who invest in your company, and you will want to focus on the output. You will want to focus on having the right ARR, the right numbers. But it's something probably wrong. The best thing when you are a young entrepreneur is to focus on the input. The input is everything that you will be able to do, everything that you will be able to have in your processes, on the product side, on the marketing side, on the sales side, building the right culture, spending some time on building those foundations, because closing a deal is not something complex. What is complex is building the core competencies of the company. And the last thing is, it's very important to have this kind of message to your team, is to have a team of drivers and not passengers. Because this time is dead. You need to have people that will help to drive the company moving forward. If some people are not interested to go into this driver seat, then they are not necessarily at their place in the startup industry. So, obviously, it was difficult to cover that during 15 minutes. This is what we do day to day, spending some time on the ground to help companies on sales hiring, attracting the right people, sales execution, how we will execute properly, and also how we can coach the manager of tomorrow. So, thank you. I'm done with my presentation. Thank you.